Only on 7, we brought you a story last week on a policy change that would stop student trainers and athletes of the opposite sex from working together at Sandia High School.
Action 7 News reporter Liz McKernan explains the details behind the principal's decision to make that policy change.
In a police report taken by APS police, the sordid details surrounding an incident that led to a school policy change at Sandia High School. According to the police report, a female student was at the gym after school when she was approached by a male student who began kissing her, then held her down by her wrists and put his hands down her pants. The female student told police the male student touched her in between her jeans and underwear, and the advances were unwanted. The teen says she told the student to stop, using his girlfriend as an excuse to get away. The male student refused to let go, but a cell phone call interrupted, freeing the girl. The report continues, describing the male student telling his alleged victim not to tell anyone. The female student told the principal about the attack. Because of that, the principal is now changing the policy regarding student trainers and athletes. Even though the incident did not happen in a locker room and the report does not make clear the victim was a student trainer, the principal will no longer allow student athletes and trainers of the opposite sex to work together. The principal says trainers cannot enter the locker rooms of the opposite sex, and the policy even goes so far as to prevent female students from being on the field providing water to male athletes. In the meantime, parents say the new policy is unfair to students in the training program. In Northeast Albuquerque, Liz McKernan, KUAT, Action 7 News.
APS police plan to turn the investigation over to the district attorney's office in the coming weeks.